This street in London is the nerve centre of the world. Well, it used to be. In the year 1500, printing pioneer Wynkyn de Worde became the first printer to set up shop on Fleet Street, but soon it was crawling with publishers. Even a royal proclamation that banned any further building on the street due to its chronic overcrowding could not stop its rise to publishing prominence. So, why Fleet Street? Well, it was conveniently situated near the Royal Courts of Justice that supplied the demand, and the River Thames that supplied, well, the supplies. Fleet Street was home to the world's first daily newspaper when the Daily Courant began being published in 1702. And over the years, many other famous publications have followed suit, such as The Times, The Daily Express, and a personal favourite of my 8-year-old self, the Beano. Fleet Street was at the peak of its power as it entered the 20th century. Nicknamed the Street of Ink, it was simply the place to be if you were a publisher. However, all good things must come to an end, and in the 1980s, many of the newspapers moved to new locations that offered modernized and, more importantly, cheaper printing. But while the publishers have left, the legacy remains, and if you're ever in London, take a walk down the Street of Ink and try to imagine what it was like back when it was the center of the publishing world.